Now next terminology we will use for bevel gear is pitch cone distance. Pitch cone distance, and we will denote it by A naught. Now here pitch cone distance is nothing but this distance. Okay. So it is a length of pitch cone elements. Okay. So it is nothing but a length of pitch cone element, and you can find this as by Pythagoras theorem. So if you consider this triangle here, if you make here a triangle, so this distance will be dg by 2, this distance will be dp by 2. Okay. So if you make here a triangle, so the triangle will be like this. Okay. Now this distance will be, total is dg. So this distance will be dg by 2. And this vertical distance will be dp by 2. And here a naught will be here. So here 90 degree angle will be here. So by Pythagoras theorem you can write a naught square is equal to dp by 2 square plus dg by 2 square, or if suppose you want a naught, so is equal to under root dp by 2 square plus dg by 2 square. So in this way you can find a naught. The next terminology is module. So module is nothing but the pitch circle diameter in mm at large end of the teeth divided by number of teeth. Okay, so module you can write pitch circle diameter at large end of teeth, we are denoting it by D, and number of teeth is Z. Okay, so it may be dp by Zp or it may be dg by Zg. Okay, so D by Z will be module. Next is a standard values of module at large end of the teeth in mm. So the standard values already we have seen in case of spur gear, in case of helical gear. So same values will you have to prefer for first choice. So I will again revise first choice of standard values of module. So 1, 1.25, 2, 2.5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 16, then 20, 25, 32, 40, and 50. Okay, so these are the standard values of module that you have to use whenever you are solving the numericals. Okay, so these values are actually same as in case of spur and helical gear we have seen. Okay. The next terminology is addendum. So addendum and dedendum, okay, HA and HF. So addendum is HA, and HA is equal to 1 module, and dedendum is HF is equal to 1.2 module. Yeah, so in this way you can calculate addendum and dedendum at large end of the teeth. Okay, the next terminology we'll use is speed ratio or you can call it as gear ratio also. So speed ratio or gear ratio, it is denoted by I, and I is nothing but NP by NG, ZG by ZP or DG by DP. The larger value should be in numerator and a smaller value should be in denominator, or you can write here tan of gamma G, because we have seen tan gamma G is nothing but dg by dp. Yeah, so it is a gear ratio. The next terminology is back cone. Back cone, so it is an imaginary cone whose elements are perpendicular to the elements of the pitch cone. You know, see here back cone, you can see pinion back cone. So pinion back cone is here from here to here. So this is the pinion back cone, and if you are considering gear, so gear back cone will be this one. Okay, so it is the cone whose elements are perpendicular to the cone pitch cone elements. Okay, so pitch cone is here, you can see here pitch cone is here and back cone is here, and here 90 degree angle is there. Okay, so this is back cone, this is pitch cone, or this is pitch cone, this is back cone of gear, and this is the pitch cone of pinion, and this is the back cone of pinion. Okay, So the back cone will be the backside cone of this pinion. Okay. The next will be back cone radius. Back cone radius. Now, if we consider here this triangle ABC, so I will draw here triangle ABC. So triangle ABC is here, and this angle is gamma P. Now see it. This triangle we have drawn here, ABC, and this angle is gamma P. So in this triangle, if suppose you want to find this back cone radius is nothing but here back cone radius is nothing but RB pinion. RB for pinion is RBP. So back cone radius will be here A to C. Okay, if you make here a circle like this, so this is nothing but a back cone. So A to C is nothing but RBP. Okay, so RBP we need to find. So RBP you can find from cos. Okay, because if suppose you are having adjacent and adjacent side is nothing but the side of this dp dp by 2 will be adjacent side, and hypotenuse will be RBP. Okay. So if we write here cos of gamma p, so cos of gamma p will be AB divided by AC. Now here AB is nothing but dp by 2, and AC is nothing but RB for pinion, back cone radius of pinion. So you can write here AB is DP by 2 and it is RBP. So therefore RBP will become DP divided by, now this 2 I am writing here 2 times cos of gamma P. Okay, so in this way you can find back cone radius of pinion. Similarly, if we calculate back cone radius, if you want to find back cone radius for gear, so we have to consider this triangle CDE, this triangle, and here this angle is gamma G. Okay, so I will draw here triangle first. Okay, here it is E, C, D, and this angle is gamma G. Okay. So here again, now see here, this D2E is nothing but total is DG. So D2E is nothing but DG by 2. And CD is nothing but your back cone radius RB for gear. Okay. So again, here adjacent and hypotenuse we are having. So we have to go for cos of gamma G. Adjacent is DG by 2 divided by RBG. So therefore, RBG is equal to DG divided by 2 times cos of gamma G. Okay, so in this way you can find back cone radius for gear. Okay, so by using this formula you can find back cone radius of gear. Then next is face width. So it is denoted by small b. So face width is nothing but the length of gear tooth measured along the pitch cone elements. Okay, now see here. Pitch cone elements are these are the pitch cone elements. The length of gear teeth measured along pitch cone elements. Okay, so here small b will be this length, your face width.